I'm Sasha.
I'm Jim.
And we are Jim and Sasha Allen.
But the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. Taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could die. So kiss me and smile for me.
My dad was actually like, do you want your name to go? We can totally put your name first. Like, that's okay. And I was like, you know, if you say Sasha and Jim, I think Jim and Sasha, it flows better. So I was offered the opportunity to have my name first. And then we decided you're the dad and it works better. But I was offered.
I like the way that doing it this way preserves your name next to our last name. So you get the Sasha Allen part. And the Jim is like, oh, that other guy at the beginning, whatever.
Okay, so besides that, who makes the decision? I'm like, let's go on the show and let's go on the show as a duo.
Yeah. My dad was the one who suggested it because he got the email about, you know, auditions are open for The Voice, and he brought it to me. And my reaction was kind of like, they would never choose us and we would never be on The Voice.
And I was like, I know, but it'll be fun to record together.
But we just were around the house because of COVID. And so I was like, all right, fine, we'll do this and I'll humor you and we'll never be on The Voice. And then slowly we're on The Voice. My dad, I think you texted me or something and you were like The Voice emailed us. And I was like, oh my God. Like, I was kind of an idiot thinking that, like, I didn't think they'd care about like our little, you know, folky duo. And that I thought we weren't really the fit that they would be looking for the show. But once we heard back from them, it was like, oh my God, like, thank God we did this.
You know, we've always sung harmony together, but sitting down to deliberately record a few songs and as best as we could and like really work on them, it got me thinking like, wow, this is so fun. I hope we get to do more of this. And we have, and I'm so grateful for that opportunity. It is totally amazing. And having been doing this for decades as a teacher and a performer and a songwriter and collaborating with amazing people through all kinds of parts of the music community around New England, this is just the ultimate for me. I'm so grateful to be working with my son.
All my bags are packed, I'm ready to go. I am standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up.
It was like, going through my head was like a few things like, don't screw this up. This is your moment. Connect to the song. Tunnel vision. If you need to black out everything else to get through it, then just do that. But it was so many months leading up to it and so much anticipation that it was this moment of almost like a deep breath, and I didn't exhale until I realized that we got through. It was like the moment that we'd been waiting for, and that we'd practiced so hard for and we'd been working for so long. It was so exciting, so stressful. It was like a million emotions wrapped into one that ended with pure joy.
I can add to that if you'd like. So walking into that space and there being a live audience there was just the greatest lift, you know? And then walking onto the stage with Sasha, you know, I think speaking for both of us, we both felt more comfortable being with each other than to be alone. That's gotta be tough on those performers to go up there alone. But not only walking up with him, but then looking over and seeing the keyboardist and band leader, Paul Merkovich, ready to count off the tune and being able to just play my mandolin while Sasha did the heavy lifting on verse one. And the band, you know, we really got to do kind of our own thing there because the music just floated in time there. And then the band joined us. And there's tremendous security walking on stage because that band, those guys, all of them are just amazing. And talk about starstruck, hanging with those guys, rehearsing with them, and getting to share a stage with that band. That is just so special, and we're really grateful to them.
Before our blind audition, I was like, this is already such an incredible experience and so once in a lifetime. It felt the entire time throughout the entire process from preparing and practicing and auditioning and everything in between, it felt like we were on top of the world because it was something we never even we dreamed about it, but we never really felt like it could be a reality. And so it's been so incredible, and coming out of COVID and coming out of not being able to perform and kind of feeling like stunted musically, it was just a great way to come out of that. It was so incredible. Yeah, there's a lot of, I mean, it was a lot of stress of, because it's obviously something that to a lot of people would be seen as controversial. Mm-hmm. And so there was an element of stress of, you know, how much do I want to share and how do I want to be seen and what do I want people to know about me? And after starting the process and considering all of these things, I kind of just decided, I felt like sharing it in the way that we did, in a way that was very open and almost very normal and relaxed, and including my parents in the discussion, I felt like it had the potential to be really powerful. And I felt like it maybe had the potential to help people navigating their own lives and journeys. And I felt like, you know what, it's 2021. How bad can the reactions be? It's probably going to be positive. And I'm just going to be open and honest and share my story, because it's definitely really important to who I am as a person and a musician.
I think the timing is important too, because all of this converged at a moment where for us as parents or us as a family, we're just at a point where we're like, well, this is not a big deal. I mean, this is also part of who Sasha is, and to the extent that he's comfortable talking about that, that's great. And it's like, you know, we kind of been there, done that, like next. Mm-hmm. And so it's nice to be doing this at a time where we are with our understanding and our, because you do have, there's a learning curve, right? And when you talk to people about this, sometimes what you realize is that, you know, oh, they say, you know, someone I love can relate to that. And that's how I really learned this more about this aspect of our common humanity. And so it was a very natural fit for this time in our lives, especially this year.
Jim, as parents, we want to protect our kids. We want to protect our family. And I think even your statements in that whole package was just as powerful, and maybe might help other parents and other families in that whole thing. I think both you guys did the most best teaching you could possibly do before you even saying no one.
That's nice. Thank you. It's about listening, right? And creating that space to hear each other and taking time to understand.
Yeah, I think we both plan on wherever we end up or wherever this road takes us, just using it as a jumping off point. We're going straight forward, and whether it's my dad's music that he writes or my music or whatever we're doing together, we're just gonna, after this, whatever happens, we're going full force into that, no plan B, because it feels like it's a path that suddenly appeared and we went for it, and it's just been an amazing journey and working out. And so we're just going to keep going with the flow, because music is what we want to do.